watching the Emmy Award-winning ABC 4 News, close to home.
A local skier survives a fall down the tallest mountain in the country. Good evening, everybody. I'm Ruth Thon.
And I'm Terry Wood. Similar falls at this very same spot on Mount McKinley have killed 15 climbers, but Ed McGinn somehow survived. ABC 4's Larry Warren is here now with the story and some exclusive video that was taken on that ill-fated climb. Larry, what happened?
Terry, the three climbers packed their skis to the top of the mountain and were skiing down. And when you're on Mount McKinley at 20,320 feet, a fall can last a long, long time.
Variable Alaska conditions.
Ed McGinn was enthused as he began his ski descent down the gully called the Orient Express, grimly named for the number of Japanese and Korean climbers who've fallen down it and died. Here's McGinn skiing part of the Orient Express safely a few days before his accident. Last Thursday, he, John Coulter, and Noah Howell climbed to the summit. Then, at the top of Orient, Ed put on his skis and dropped in.
He went over, and then appeared that he tried to ride himself, tried to get his feet underneath him, and that didn't happen. He went over, and then it was like that, and he was just cartwheeling, tomahawking, head over heels.
You know, I knew it was bad. This is bad. I got to stop. When I could no longer stop, and that became futile, I realized death was imminent. I said, this is how it ends.
Did it look survivable?
No. I knew he was dead. I saw a rock, which I thought might be his body.
But it was his friend's backpack. McGinn fell 3,100 vertical feet down the side of Mount McKinley and left the pack to walk out.
And my eyes were packed with snow, scratched my corneas, and I came closer to dying from suffocation than I did from blood trauma.
Rangers helped McGinn to the party's base camp at 14,000 feet, stabilized him, and flew him out.
There's been 15 deaths in it in the last 20 years. And for him to not have broken a bone, it's funny. It's comical now. I mean, it's it's unbelievable.
I don't believe it was sheer luck. It just wasn't my time.
Now here's some perspective. McGinn's fall was the equivalent of falling from the top of the Snowbird tram, sliding downhill and not stopping until reaching the parking lot. He was flown to a hospital, checked over, and walked out with bruises, cuts, and scrapes, but alive and ready to try the Orient Express again.
Oh, you're kidding.
Someday.
Wow.